Davis Monthan Air Force Base, flying the JATO profile with the J's and doing it better than you could do with JATO bottles.
Unbelievable.
Here we go. Watch out of the airplane. Watch about takeoff. All 164,000 pounds, which he's fully loaded. Hard to believe that they were developing the C-130, the earlier models. They actually landed one on board an aircraft carrier. How's that for a tie into the Navy? Here we go. Air Force back on the roll. As they depart the pattern, we're going to give them just a second. Won't take them long. And then Purple, now that she's had time to settle in high atop the staircase to the stars, Dan McLaren's Mach 1 air show trailer, we have from those once great horsemen of the United States Army. Still carrying the cavalry hat today when they're on the ground. Watch this Apache. Down low. Right there on the deck, swinging back around here to engage the enemy. This sort of sets the tone before the world famous Rhode Island Combined Arms Demonstration begins. This year, we have something new for you. Move down to the left. That, my friends, it's a big, giant can of whoop, fill in the rest, but it will soon be right in front of us. If you hear the sound of my voice, start making your way on up to the fence, because the Rhode Island Combined Arms Demonstration is about to begin. And before this begins, the Rhode Island Guardsmen, the Pennsylvania Guard that are flying those Apaches, they are here to protect us. So they understand that we need to do this right now. Heather Wick. Heather Wick. Can you just look around, folks, and ask the person beside you? I mean, everybody that can hear my voice, just ask it. Are you Heather Wick? It's a young girl that has gone missing. Heather Wick. Heather Wick. Come meet your mother in front of the family tent, or find anyone in a uniform, Heather Wick, find a grown-up, and say, hey, they were paging me. Ask somebody to help you, Heather Wick. If you're an adult, listen to me, if you're an adult and you find Heather Wick, ask any uniformed personnel, they will take her with you, perhaps, to the family tent, where her mother is waiting for her. Heather Wick. Heather Wick, ask an adult for help, take you to the family tent to find your mother. Now listen, ladies and gentlemen, this is an important announcement. Serious, listen up here. If you have a kid here with you, make a family plan. Make a family plan. Have it placed to me should you become separated. Heather Wick. Heather Wick, grab an adult, tell him you're Heather Wick, and say, hey, get me to the family tent, okay? Let's get this young girl back. And make a family plan so no one else gets lost. Now, ladies and gentlemen, here to tell us all about the world famous Rhode Island Combined Arms Demonstration, it's the voice of this display, Lieutenant Colonel Mike McCary. Take it away, sir.
Thank you, Matt. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this year's Combined Arms Demonstration. I'm Lieutenant Colonel Michael McCarron, Operations Support Squadron Commander and C-130J Instructor Pilot, serving in your Rhode Island Air National Guard. I'll be your narrator as we showcase the combat capabilities of your Air and Army National Guard during a simulated enemy airfield seizure and capture of an enemy high-value target. In contrast to some of the other outstanding performances you've seen today, this demonstration is the integration of the combat tasks these professionals would normally accomplish under hostile fire, and leave no question that the National Guard stands ready to bring the fight to the enemy and defend our homeland. The Rhode Island National Guard units involved in today's demonstration are the 143rd Airlift Wing flying the C-130J Hercules, Alpha and Charlie Company, 1st Battalion, 126th Aviation flying the UH-60 Blackhawks, Alpha Company, 1st Battalion, 169th Aviation, flying the CH-47 Chinooks. 6 of the 6th Cavalry, 10th Combat Action Brigade, flying the AH-64 Apache. Now, Major Michael Fanning, the Air Mission Commander, will check in with the Assault Force. Let's listen to the live cockpit checks.
Right arm, check it. Ready, 1, 2, 4.1.
Today's combined arms demonstration puts you in the middle of hostile action behind enemy lines. You are looking at a valuable airfield controlled by the enemy, and our mission is to seize control of this airfield as efficiently as possible. As you enjoy today's demonstration, keep in mind that brave men and women of the Army and Air National Guard are currently engaged in combat and humanitarian operations just like this throughout the world, voluntarily putting themselves in harm's way each day to defend the rights and freedoms that all Americans hold dear. Today, we honor the memory of those who have given their lives in the defense of this great nation, and we salute those currently deployed around the globe. At Show Center, the AH-64D Apaches are commencing their attack on enemy positions with Hellfire missiles and high explosive rockets. With enemy positions suppressed, ground forces are inbound. Watch as the CH-47 Chinook is inbound with a 9,300-pound M777 howitzer from the Rhode Island Army National Guard's 1st Battalion, 103rd Field Artillery. The Chinook is followed by two Rhode Island National Guard UH-60 Blackhawks with two Humvees weighing approximately 6,500 pounds apiece. A great deal of skill and experience is required when flying with external loads. Watch as our expert National Guard aviators maneuver these aircraft. you can see a flight of two UH-60 Blackhawks inbound with a ground assault force. These soldiers will rapidly exit the helicopters and immediately take up fighting positions as they secure the airfield. A low altitude tactical approach at 500 feet, maximizing aircraft performance and minimizing exposure to enemy fire. Using the C-130J's unique ability to carry heavy loads into short, unimproved runways, the crew of Rhode 1 will land and unload a light utility vehicle, capturing a high value target. Just demonstrated the tactical assault landing capability of the C-130J. It is this unique capability that allowed the 143rd Airlift Squadron to excel during military operations globally. The loadmasters aboard Rhode 1 will now take charge and direct the onload of the vehicle and high-value target. While the onload is in progress, the pilots will reconfigure the aircraft in preparation for the assault takeoff, allowing the 120,000-pound aircraft to leap off the runway in less than 2,000 feet. In doing this, the crew of Rhode 1 ensures the aircraft is on the ground for a minimal amount of time. The crew's ability to work rapidly and efficiently while under fire in support of Army counterparts is a testament to the skill and dedication of our National Guardsmen. High-value target has been captured and is being loaded onto the aircraft and is now secured. Make up your Rhode Island National Guard. Most of us were born and raised right here in New England. We're your family, friends, neighbors, and co-workers. For a few of us, this is a full-time career, but for most National Guard members, it's the best part-time job you could ever imagine. Some of the aircraft you'll see are based right here at Quonset Point. Others are based throughout the region. As part of our day-to-day operations, we fly training routes throughout New England. Maybe you've seen us flying over your neighborhood. If you haven't, it won't be long, so keep an eye out for us now that you know what we look like and what we do. At home or overseas, we are all proud to serve and are honored to be part of the rich heritage of the National Guard. Our ground assault force needs additional critical supplies. If you look behind you to your right, Lieutenant Colonel Mark Vincent Query and the crew of Rhode 2 are ready. Airdrop is the fastest and most efficient way to get supplies to remote or hostile locations with a containerized delivery system, or CDS. These bundles consist of anything from bottled water to ammunition and even a spy vehicle. The United States has been using this airdrop decade for years to supply our troops, as well as to provide humanitarian relief to people throughout the world. Right now on board Rhode 2 from your right, the C-130J's advanced avionics are giving the pilots guidance and speed cues to meet exact time on target requirements. One, two successful bundles delivered on time and on target. Now watch the precision timing required as Rhode 1 takes off to rejoin with Rhode 2, the airdrop aircraft. The enemy is attempting a counterattack utilizing improvised explosive devices and mortars. Our ground assault force reacts quickly and decisively to suppress and destroy the remaining enemy forces. The leadership and professionalism displayed by our infantry soldiers is second to none. Even in the face of danger and extreme adversity, they adapt and overcome, dominating the battle space and protecting our freedom. During the enemy attack, one of our soldiers was severely wounded. The ground force commander has requested immediate evacuation. A dust-off UH-60 is already on site. Although severe injury or even the ultimate sacrifice is sometimes an unavoidable cost for our military personnel, they are able to continue their mission with confidence. Our medical evacuation and casualty care capabilities are second to none. The dust-off crew you're watching is a combination of dedicated aviation and medical professionals, ensuring the combat survivability of our fighting forces. It is a responsibility they do not take lightly. Company C, Versatile 126, has deployed multiple times to Afghanistan and Iraq in support of Operation Enduring Freedom. These soldiers provided critical medical care to wounded soldiers throughout the battlefield and were responsible for the preservation of American lives. Position to escort dust-off aircraft to the combat support hospital. Is complete. The high-value target is captured, and the mission is successful, and the remaining U.S. personnel have exfiltrated the area. C-130Js execute a beam approach. At this time, time, I'd like to present the crews of the Connecticut Army National Guard's 1st Battalion, 169th Aviation, flying the CH-47 Chinook. Battalion 126 Aviation flying the UH-60 Blackhawk. And the Pennsylvania 6 of the 6 Cavalry flying the AH-64D Apache. And the Rhode Island Army National Guard 103rd Field Artillery. The right base turn to final, flying the T-130J Hercules, crews from the Rhode Island Air National Guard's 143rd Airlift Wing. On the ground and in the air have successfully completed their mission and now await further battle orders. The demonstration you have just watched was a small example of the capabilities and professionalism of the citizen soldiers and airmen of your Rhode Island and Connecticut National Guard. Intense peacetime training like this allows for greater success on the overseas battlefield. It is this training that keeps your Rhode Island National Guard at the highest state of readiness. This concludes our combined arms demonstration. Speaking on behalf of the Rhode Island National Guard, I thank you for your continued support of Guard members in your community.